Welcome to Emily Kate Made This. I am Emily Kate and I'm coming to you from Berlin in Germany. Welcome to my knitting, sewing, general crafty YouTube channel. This is a place where we talk about knitting. There are things moving behind me. This is a place where we talk about knitting and sewing and general crafty things. This is episode 41 and yeah, let's get to it. I am already unsure about my hairstyle on the internet. I can't tell if this is granny chic or just simply granny. I've been using these pin curlers and then I stuck it up in a net, and then when I look in a mirror, I think, yeah, that looks nice, that works, and it keeps the curls in for an extra day or a few hours. And then sometimes I look at pictures, or like right now, and I think, I kind of look like the queen, R.I.P. What do you think? Maybe I should take it down already. Let's take it down. Let's go with that. I am growing out my fringe and it's troublesome. I feel so bald. Maybe like that, but now I look just 1980s. Anyway, you are not here to talk about my hair. You are here to hear about my knitting. So, let's discuss. I don't have any finished objects. I do have one half finished object, but it needs some surgery. And actually, I would really, really appreciate some help if any of you have any to offer. So, you may recall, if you were here last time, that I cast on a pair of slippers for myself and finished them. And then I was going to cast some on for my husband, but realized that they would be too, the pattern wouldn't work out. So I cast on the Elf Slippers by, or I don't know yet, and it was all going swimmingly. I figured out how to do the cast on, all was well, and I did the heel because the construction starts with the heel. Here it is. Said heel. But once I had finished the whole length of the sock, or slipper, and thought, yes, it fits him, this is marvellous, we put it on his actual foot and discovered that the heel only, like, tickled the base of his actual heel, like, ankle. It didn't quite reach his ankle. So I added some extra to the heel. I think I added an extra 2.5 centimeters, and that was fine, but he didn't want it at the front, so I could only add it at the back. And when you make this pattern, you do the heel and then you separate for the opening, but they're kind of equal, so when you then finish the slipper and pick up the stitches, you just pick up one stitch, a bit like a sock, and go around. But of course I had this extra inch of fabric, so I had to pick up extra stitches. I was also concerned that it wouldn't fit on his foot, because when I made mine, the I-cord bind-off was quite tight, and I thought it would never go around his heel, so the extra stitches wouldn't be a problem. But as you can see, it's massive. Like, it's floppy and not good. I picked up, I think, 5 stitches here, 5 stitches here, and did the normal bind off, but I did go up a couple of needle sizes. But I don't know if I rip it back and do the whole pick up again from the heel and the foot, whether it's simply that I did too many picked up too many stitches, and maybe I should have picked them up and then immediately decreased them out on the next round. There isn't really a next round though, because you pick them up and then you do the I-cord. but maybe I'd have to do an extra round to decrease them back to the stitch count it should be. Or pick it up as normal, and don't use bigger needles and use the same 3.25, I think, needles. Or is there actually a specific technique that you're supposed to do and I just didn't, when you need the heel to be bigger? Because the pattern is not designed for a man's foot, but I know that people make these for the whole family. People make slippers for everybody. So I don't know if I just missed out, I should have done something different, or if it's the I-cord situation. What would you do? Or what have you done? Please let me know. Because I have just cast on the second one. I desperately tried to record a tutorial. That's a bit extreme. Basically, to show you what I did, because a lot of people also got confused with the cast on for these slippers, and I tried to cast these on a couple of years back and I didn't know how to and I didn't understand. And I figured it out. Don't know that it's like the perfect way, but it worked, obviously. And it worked on the other one, so I think it worked. If I can edit that video into a way that is cohesive and makes sense, I will add it to the end of the video. But until then, yes, don't quite know what to do here because that's really floppy. Did consider maybe adding elastic, but then I don't know. He doesn't need extra elasticy pulley-inniness. At the front, just here where it's all folded. Yeah, him and knitting, they're just not a good combination. Like me knitting for him. I'm also having some slight post-traumatic situations from his jumper. The weather's been so pants here in Germany this summer. And it's been like 16 to 19 degrees Celsius and rainy and super windy. My tomato plants did not survive this weather. They got blown down by the wind and snapped in half, and it was very soul destroying. We will move on. Basically, he wore his jumper a couple of days in a row, yesterday and the one before. And even though it has short rows, and if you hold the jumper up like this, you can see that there's a back neck and the front. It does sit like a jumper that has short rows, but when he puts it on, the neckline comes up like this and the back drops like this. And it's not that he's putting it on backwards, because if he turns it around, the same thing happens, but a lot worse, because there's obviously more stitching. So he's understandably not very comfortable, because his front neck is being itched and pushed into and scratched by the jumper, but the back of his neck is cold. And I don't really know what happened. I did the short rows, as I said, and you can see that they're short rows. Is it simply that it needs more short rows, or do men need some different kind of shaping for their broader shoulders? I don't know. Because if you watched that episode, I'll try and link it somewhere. If you watched that episode, I did mention that it's quite tight on his shoulders, like he's like a triangle, and then it gets really baggy at the back. But it's like, it's too loose and too big. I don't know. Have any of you had any of these issues before, and how did you fix them? I don't know if they're fixable post-jumper making. I know I could potentially like cut it and knit from the neck up and fix it, but the problem is that the short rows are really confusing, as I will get back into, because I may have cast on something. But I basically don't think that I would be able to do it with that one, and maybe I will just knit a different jumper pattern the next time, and I'm thinking bottom up, because then I could definitely get it correct. And I'm even considering, which probably isn't a surprise to any of you who have been here a while, a vintage pattern, because that's specifically shaped to your body. Especially if you use the calculations like Squidney's School of Vintage Knitting. If your shoulders are 10 centimeters long or wide or that deep, you can adjust your stitch count to make it fit you. So if I can get his measurements and then I could knit spot on, that would be marvelous. So yeah, how did I get onto his jumper when I'm not talking about that? Anyway, I did. So please help if you know how, and please help and advise if you know how. I've already cast on the heel, and this heel, the heel for me takes me, when I say 3 days, I don't mean like I sit there solidly for 3 days, but I can only knit for about 45 minutes to an hour every day because my hands hurt too much if I do any more. So it's basically like 3-4 hours for me to knit the heel, and I've got to make it longer. But then after that, I don't quite know what to do. I will quickly mention the yarn. It is Novita Seven Brothers. It is the wool and tencel combination. I think it's called Nature. And the colours are delightful. I chose these colours for him because it would match his jumper. Kind of. This is how far I have got with the second. I just cast on. I don't know if I can actually add in the video that I did, so maybe I will briefly mention what I did. So I did Judy's Magic Cast On, as advised in the book, but it says to cast on 2 stitches in the main colour, and obviously you can't see it now because I've already knitted a row, but I casted on the 2 white stitches first, then I used the contrast colour and I made a slip knot, and I added that to the needle that next, I would have next done the next stitch with the white, but instead I put slipknot purple on, and then I knitted the purple on the other side, left that yarn aside, picked up the white again, continued the magic, Judy's Magic Cast On method for the next 4 stitches, 2 on each pin, then did the same, like dropped that white one, picked up the purple, did those 2, dropped that, picked up the white, etc, etc. That is how I did it. Sounds super simple, and it's basically what the book says. About 4 years I did not understand, and I know I'm not alone. I really hope you can't hear that. My husband's having a shower. It's quite loud. So a couple of episodes back, I asked for your help. I said, please help, I don't know which jumper to cast on. I'm going to Sweden in September and I want a jumper or cardigan for it. It was very 50-50 on the second Yggdrasil to match, not to match my husband, but that is the same as my husband's jumper, or the Fable Knitwear forest berry jacket. It was basically 50-50, and every time someone said forest berry, I was like, yes, that's it. Then someone would say the Yggdrasil, I'm like, oh yeah, that's it. And I think about 2 weeks passed, maybe longer, and I didn't cast anything on because I could not make a decision. Then I really wanted to cast on different vintage cardigan, then a different jumper, and in the end I realized you need to make a decision fast because you're going in a month, and the Yggdrasil is the most likely to be finished in time, or at least for me to finish whilst I'm there. But then I had a bit of a faux pas because I cast on and I managed to twist my stitches at some point when I joined in the round. And I have never done that before. I've seen it and I've heard about it, and I technically may have done it once before to my poor mother, who cast on a really long welt with like 400 stitches on fingering weight yarn, and that was twisted, and that was potentially my fault. But to myself, I've never done that. So I managed to do all the ribbing, start on the short rows, and then realize this looks very strange. So I had to rip it back. Then I said, okay, because you kind of guesstimate how much yarn you need if it says cast on, say 100 stitches, I'm doing the twisted German cast on. So I wrap it around my needle, say 10 times, and then I use that and kind of do this with the yarn until I've got about 10 times that amount. And sometimes, if I'm very unlucky, I will run out of yarn. Usually I end up with an enormous amount of extra yarn. And I got to the end of this jumper of casting on with about that much of the cast on, of the tail left. That was close. So I almost cast on the forest berry jumper jacket because I said, if this second time doesn't work, I'm not doing it a third, it's a sign. But it just about did. So joined it all, checked a bazillion times, I did not twist it. And I have cast on. I don't have a cable that's big enough, and I don't know why, because I haven't been using my Chiago needles in a while. I've been using the liquor needles, so I don't know where the cable has gone, but alas, this is how far we are. And as I said in my husband's jumper video, not 100% certain if I'm doing the cable correctly, but I think I am. If I read it, the instructions, then I read it and that is what I'm doing. But when I look at the actual cable diagram, I don't know. I don't know if I'm doing it right. So the cable runs down the arms, the front and the back. I am still knitting the yoke, the raglan. I haven't split for the sleeves yet. I am not 100% sure how long to knit this for. The size of one, the jumper's designed to have negative ease, which I like, and I like because it's closer to the vintage style knitting that I'm currently very into. But it's 29 inches. I don't have the centimeters next to me. I'll try and remember to write it down. I'm roughly a 32, 33 bust, depending on the day, the time, time of day. But the smaller size is 29 inches and it's recommended to have, I'm just gonna go get it because I'm saying all this without being 100%. The finished bust circumference is 75 centimeters or 29.5 inches, and it is recommended to have 8 to 10 centimeters of negative ease or 3 to 4 inches of negative ease. So technically, size 1 would work because the second size is 85 centimeters or 33 inches, and that would be the correct size, depending, because it could be actually like an extra inch. But when I look at the size of this jumper, it looks like a toddler's jumper. It looks so minuscule. I've checked my gauge and the same thing occurred as it did last time. Interestingly enough, I'm using the Svensk Ull by Yabo and I've added the Knitting for Olive Rust Orange color, mohair, and I have the exact same gauge as I did without the mohair. So I had 20 stitches in 10 centimeters, but when I blocked it, it became 18, which is what the pattern recommends. So theoretically, I have done all of my raglan increases. This should be the correct size to then split for the sleeves. But I'm looking at it and thinking, I don't know. So I think I will try and pop this onto another cable and then lay it next to one of my other raglan jumpers and see. Problem is, most of my jumpers are a bit oversized, so it's not going to be very accurate, but it might give me a general idea. and to measure the length or depth and see. I may just go to the second size, and then my idea is to actually potentially make it more of a vintage fit. The current in fashion jumpers and styles in general are what I have always dreamed of becoming. I always dreamt, basically I love massive oversized clothes. They're very comfortable, and when you're all hot and sweaty, all your clothes don't stick to you, and if you're feeling rather large that day because you ate an entire cake, whatever, it doesn't matter because your clothes are so loosey-goosey and it's all fine. But that is now in fashion, and I am currently very into the vintage style. And to be honest, I'm very short and I'm very small. Like, my frame is very small, so I look very like I'm drowning in fabric if I wear oversized things. And if I'm honest, they're not that comfortable as a day-to-day thing because I get my sleeves stuck in things. I can't fit my sleeves in coats, for example. Everything just flaps around, and I actually prefer to wear tight things like leggings, but they're not really socially appropriate to go out in just leggings anymore. They used to be. Anyway, I don't currently enjoy the fact that everything in my wardrobe doesn't really fit my current aesthetic or dream aesthetic, nor do they go together whatsoever. If I have a big baggy dress and then a baggy jumper, I don't like my own silhouette. I think I just look like I'm wearing a tent or a potato sack. I just feel uncomfortable because I look so like fabric engulfed. And a lot of my jumpers, if I lift my arms, the whole jumper goes up. And if I want to wear my trousers that are, they are high-waisted, but I'm very short-waisted, so things don't sit on my body like they do on the average body because I'm just a very small person. So things aren't in the proportions as they are on others. So my trousers fall down a little bit, and then my crop tops, cropped jumpers sit just above. So I've always got this small gap where there's the jumper slightly too short. But if I wear a dress, then I want the jumper to sit at my waist so that it gives me some kind of shape and I'm not just one straight fabric mountain. So I basically need to have a triplet set. I need to have a long-sleeved, long version of a jumper, a cropped short-sleeved version, and then a cardigan that goes over that I can alternate depending what I'm wearing. Because this jumper, for example, this is my Ranunculus. This one is kind of cropped, and I've got the raglan, and one day I will make this jumper again, and I will not add the raglan increases because I don't need, my armpit is here, I don't need all this extra fabric, and it just, that's not the look I need or the temperature that I require to lift my arms up, and then my entire jumper comes up into the air. And every jumper I basically own is too short if I want to wear it with trousers or a skirt. And I could wear it with these, some of them, but they're so wide that if there's a gust of wind or if it's generally just cold, everything's just so wide because everything is boxy, because everything in fashion is boxy, that I'm just cold. Even if I'm wearing something woolly, the air just flows straight up. And people are very into knitting things at a loose gauge, and like this jumper is knit on 6mm needles. Mine isn't, but the pattern. And it's all loose and airy and flowy and big, and it's not working for me. So all that to say, I'm thinking I might make this jumper as negative ease as I figure out, and then I might make it shaped and slight and longer than the pattern, because although I like Anna's style and I like the fact that when she wears her dress, she has the same idea. She wears a dress that goes with the gathers, so she makes her clothes tighter and cropped so she gets a waist. But she's quite busty and I'm not particularly busty, so I don't get this defined shape and I just get cold. So I'm thinking, I've got lots of thoughts, but I'm thinking I will make this more shaped, come down lower, and possibly add a welt to the bottom, which is the big ribbing that you'll see in vintage knits. And potentially I might even put a belt like around the center where my waist is to bring it in, to make a shape. Basically, I'm going through a phase of desperately trying to get between 1930s and 1950s style and shape, and like get my wardrobe to actually be cohesive and work. And I've always been interested in these decades. I just don't know how to dress. I don't know how to dress myself. I don't know how to choose the right colors, shades, shapes, lines. Like, I can watch a movie and think, I love her outfit. But then if you turn the TV off and they ask me, what was she wearing? A dress? I'm not very good at actually remembering or taking in information and then being able to process it and turn my wardrobe into that. This is a very blabby, chatty episode. So basically, I've been knitting this Yggdrasil thinking I wanted to make this jumper for so long, but now it doesn't really fit into my style. So I'm going to make it fit into my style because I love the cable and I like pattern. So I'm going to make it work. But it has to be longer and fit me. One day I will have a wardrobe full of clothing that I actually can wear together, that actually function, like keep me warm, and that I look nice, because currently I feel like I often look like I've gone to my parents' wardrobe and taken out a bunch of stuff and put it together and then gone outside. And then I see pictures or videos and I think, oh. And it's not that I'm caring what other people think, it's more how I feel and how I see these pictures, and they're not representing what I actually want to dress like at all. So yeah, there's my rant of the day. So I've got about 3 weeks to finish my husband's second slipper and to finish this jumper. Let's see if that happens. My goal is to finish them both. If I don't finish the jump, I have to finish the slipper and I have to fix the slipper and mend it, the first one. And if I don't finish the Yggdrasil jumper, then I will bring it with me and potentially block it when I am there, or just bring it so I have something to knit on. And yeah, we'll see. We'll see if I manage. My second work in progress is kind of a potential work in progress slash might not become a work in progress. It will, but not the one that it was destined to be, potentially. When I was in the UK, I was knitting away with my mother and she knitted the welt for me for the Victory jumper, which is the vintage knit. And I decided I would do it in the round. Now, this was before the days of Squidney's School of Vintage Knitting and using your gauge to calculate how many stitches you need to cast on, etc., etc. And I did some miscellaneous maths and I spent yesterday the whole morning trying to figure out where I plucked these numbers from, why I chose these needles, why I chose these numbers. I still can't figure it out. But I basically had some leftover yarn from my chevron jumper, the blue one, that was knitted in drops Nord, and that was given to me just as I started learning to knit in 2020. And I had a couple of balls left over, and I asked my mom to cast on the welt for me. And based off the knowledge of the two jumpers I had not even finished, I chose this cast-on number. So my blue chevron, I knitted the welt on 2.25mm needles, and I did something like 168 stitches as my cast-on. And then the green chevron, I ended up having all kinds of chaos, and I ended up using the sleeves. They had 80 stitches for the body times two, so 160. So I chose 164 stitches using 3mm needles, and my mum cast on in the round. It is so tiny, but I did put it on over my head yesterday and over my waist, and it does fit. So now I'm very confused, because when I laid this on top of my two jumpers, it is so tiny. But I did knit those jumpers flat. Oh, my bread is ready. Hold on. I am back. What was I saying? Yes, they were knitted flat, so the ribbing would be different, and they were knitted on different needles, and basically this should fit. It just looks tiny. I mean, it does physically fit over me, but the stitch count, I don't know where I got that from. It's not the same as the original, but that yarn is a sport weight yarn, and the one in the pattern is for a light fingering equivalent. Obviously, it was for vintage yarn, so it's not available anymore. Most people that have used this pattern have changed the gauge because it's for a 32-inch bust, and most people are not that, and they want a bigger gauge, so they've changed numbers or they've changed the yarn, and I want the small one. I want the size 32-inch, so I'm messing it with it the other direction, using a thicker yarn, but changing the gauge to make it smaller. And I've got myself in a bit of a pickle because I don't quite understand where I was going with my maths back then, and yet I know it fits, so it should work. But I don't have any more of this drops yarn. And for some reason I thought I would use it to get rid of it, but I need to buy more to be able to make the rest of the jumper. I only have the blue, and I have about 40 grams left of the blue, but I still need to buy red and white, which means it's not really stash busting, it's buying new yarn, and I don't want actually to be knitting in drops Nord, because it's got polyamide and nylon and it's superwash. So I don't even want to buy the yarn anyway. I did think about buying the alpaca, because that's just 100% alpaca, and that could work. But equally, I don't want to buy new yarn. But then equally, I've cast on already. So I've got, my mind is in two places. I do have different leftover drops Nord. That is a denim blue color, and maybe I will make a different vintage pattern using that yarn and combine it with this one. I'll worry about that stitch count another time. Or I leave it for a little bit and eventually buy some alpaca and do actually make this into the victory jumper and using a different yarn. Or I just leave that aside, worry about that in the future, and actually buy like Swedish yarn or something, for example, in the blue, white and red, and make it non-superwash in possibly even fingering weight yarn, and maybe even use the actual numbers in the pattern, who knows. So yeah, I'm a bit confused, but I know I want this jumper, so it will happen at some point. But I already have the welt that my mum made, so I kind of want to use that so I don't have to knit the welt. I have one new future, very soon future, potential cast on that I wanted to show you, even though it hasn't been cast on yet. I needed to get the needles for the neck band off of my Yggdrasil so that I could use the same needles to cast on the neck of another jumper. And then when I did get those needles, I thought, no, I need to finish at least the top of this Yggdrasil before I cast on a second jumper, because for some reason I feel like once you've split for the body, then you can cast on another jumper. And it's kind of a stash busting splash. I saw these yarns and I immediately put them together with the pattern. But the problem, as I previously mentioned, is I'm currently not into the modern style as much, and it's kind of putting a problematic situation on most of the jumper patterns that I own that I want to make, because they're not really going to fit into my style. But if I style them in a way, or make them in a way that's more vintage, that could help. So the same idea as I had for the Yggdrasil is to make this next jumper into more of a vintage silhouette, but probably more of a 1950s, 60s silhouette, because it is a yoke. I believe they came into fashion a bit more in the 50s, 60s. This jumper will be the Avena sweater by Jennifer Steingass, and I was given some beautiful hand-dyed yarn by Magda from Magda Knits, and it is glorious. And when she sent it to me, because she is so lovely, I immediately thought of putting it into this jumper and mixing it with a different yarn that I was given, I think, from one of my mum's friends' stash down jobbies. Oh, it smells so sheepy in here. Way back when, I ordered a bunch of DK yarn that turned out to be like really bulky yarn, and it didn't work in any of the patterns I had destined it for. So it's very thick, and I did use this yarn to make the vintage 1950s cardigan, because that required a bulky yarn, and this was definitely bulky enough. And I use smaller needles for that. But I think this should work in the Avena, and it will be on smaller needles. And I'm really, really hoping it works, because otherwise I don't know what to do with this yarn. But it's a really warm yarn, so it would keep me nice and toasty. And I'm going to mix that with Magda's freshly caked up skein of Ryland wool. And then when I run out of that, I'll mix it with this Rowan Hemp Tweed. And that should all blend, because I do believe there are two colours, two different yarns that you do use in the pattern for that yokey loveliness. So that is the plan. And I was thinking, if I cast it on and get the colour work done, I could then do the body in Sweden. But if you have been here a while, you will know I'm not very fast at knitting. So I don't quite know why I think I can manage a slipper and then two jumpers before 3 weeks. It's not gonna happen. But I might just cast it on for funsies and see where I get to. But that is also a plan, and I'm going to again try and make it so that it will have more of a fitted shape, waist shaping, instead of just this box that hangs off. And this is all sitting nice and cozily in a project bag I made with my mum. Cute, huh? I would say that is everything for now. I have a whole bunch of sewing stuff that I could talk about and will talk about, but not today. And I will get back to my knitting. I just thought I'd have a quick catch up with what I'm doing, what I'm up to in my knitting sphere, knitting world, and ask for your help. Speaking of which, please help. with the algorithm and like and subscribe and comment and do all the things so that YouTube will like me again. Ooh, kicking my camera. Thank you very, very much for watching my chaos of the day, and have a lovely rest of your week, and I will see you again soon. Bye!